Hi students, how are you all? I hope you're all doing fine. You're done with your examinations. Today, welcome to second semester. I'm your English teacher. Today we shall be dealing about the pros to my countrymen. Children, who's the president of India? Who's the current president of India? Ramnath Kovind. Very good. Who's the female president? Who was the female president of our India? And also the first woman president of India? Yes, it is Pratibha Patil. Before to Pratibha Patil, who was the president? It is Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Correct, children. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. You all have read about this famous and great personality. Children, he has written n number of books. He has written many essays, and as well as he was a great scientist, and he served India from 2002 to 2007. Isn't it, children? Yes. So this Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam has written so many books. Among those are Ignited Minds. He has written also another book, India 2020. It's a big title, children. India 2020. Its full title is A Vision for the New Millennium. Here, the book Ignited Minds is a very short book which consists of only 200 plus pages. Or 205 to 10 pages, children. Here, this extract, the prose which they have given for you, has been taken from Ignited Minds, written by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Okay? Open page number 139, there you will see it. And this is the famous personality, that is Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Okay? You all have read in other subjects. What is the full form of APJ? That's your assignment. You will go and you will find out where he was born. He was born in Tamil Nadu. The complete details, you can just browse it, or if you have read it, just recall that one. Okay? So, this Ignited Minds, what it actually deals with? This book was written by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam when he met a student. Usually he was the person who loved to spend time with the students. When he met a student called Sneha Thakkar, she asked a question, who is our enemy? There he got so many ideas, and the ultimate answer was, to India, it is, the enemy is poverty. It is poverty. Ignited Minds, ignited matlab kuch aag dena, like it, we have to be more creative. That's the word Ignited Minds. If we give a spark to our mind, it acts. If we give always rest and rest and rest to our mind, it actually, the brain will not work, the mind will not work properly. But if we give it a work, if we give a spark to it, if we keep our minds busy in doing one or the other thing, one or the other creative things, then that's the time where our minds get ignited, where we get different ideas related to our environment, related to our society, or the people who are very famous today, the great personalities, the entrepreneurs, the businessmen, and all, they haven't worked based like everybody had money, everybody had power. There are people who have been raised from slums, who are billionaires today. They all have worked by their creativity. Okay? This Ignited Mind, let me see. The following is an extract from Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam's book, Ignited Minds. As I already told you, let us read the extract and understand his message to the youth of India. As you all know, India is the only nation which, like, India is the nation who is standing at the leading position when it comes to the age of like 20 to 27 or 20, 18 to 24, usually that age is considered as youth age. So in India is the first, India takes the first position in the when it comes to the most youth populated country. But most populated country is China and India stands at second position. But when it comes to the youth, then India stands at the first position. All through this book, I have spoken about the power of imagination. What is imagination? I sit here and I imagine something. For example, I might have given, example, just assume, I might have given an assignment for you. You sit and you think over, okay, how do I have to do my assignment? What if I use this idea? Okay, what if I take an A4 size sheet and what if I cut it across and do something very new? Okay, at least not apart from assignment. Okay, tomorrow I have to present a seminar in the class. What do I have to do? Okay, I can use chart, I can use blackboard, I can also use computer. These are all creative ideas. We imagine what to do. And imagination is something that actually occurs in our mind. Okay? It is like we imagine, okay, what do I have to tell now? If somebody poses me a question, how can I answer it? I imagine and I tell it, isn't it? That's, imagination has more power. So only we always say, keep work to your mind. Don't ask your brain to be idle. Give one or the other work. Solve mathematical problems, solve grammar, speak, which you don't know, learn something very new. That's where imagination can be developed. It lies at the heart of the creative process and is the very substance of life, allied as it is far to attract to us what we most desire. What if today, if I tell you, okay, I'll be making the most favorite dish, take it? Okay, I want something very new out of it. Usually we prepare biryani at home. You tell to your mother, mother, I don't want a normal biryani. Make it something very new. I want a biryani flavor, but in a new taste. Your mother thinks, okay, how can I make, or you yourself are making, how can I make biryani in a very different taste? What are the other ingredients I can put into it? If not biryani, then you take it, whatever you want. I want to make a chaat today. How can I make it? What new ideas, what new creativity I can use it? Where does that creativity come from? It comes from our mind, isn't it? It comes from our mind. It is actually something like, I wanted that one. I desire that one. Desire means, mujhe wo khwahish hai, and I want everybody to look into it. That's actually what imagination is, which has the power to attract anybody. Example, you take today Dhirubhai Ambani or Ambani. Okay? You see, he had some creative ideas. He put it across as a business and today everybody is attracted by him. Why? Because he had the power to attract anybody by his creativity. That's where the power of imagination lies. Here it is, what it is telling. This power makes all the difference between the winners and the losers. Only this power, the power of imagination, can make you either a winner or a loser. If I imagine that, no, I want to come first in the class, definitely I can achieve it. What if I think, no, I don't want to. If anybody wants to come, let them come. Then you are the loser. That's simple. I would like to see in 20 years a literate and party-free India. I dream of an India governed by noble leaders. I dream of a system where the work of scientists and technologists is focused on a specific missions driven by goals relevant to the common man. How is this dream to be made real? Here he's telling, he imagines India to be literate and poverty free, where everybody is getting a formal education and nobody is poor in this country. He imagines India to be like that. He had imagined India to be poverty free and everybody has to get at least formal education. Okay? And he thinks, or he imagines India to be focused on relevant goals. There are scientists, there are technologists, there are many other technicians, where he wants Indians to be focused on a goal. Okay, now I want India to be poverty free. How can I make it? How can I achieve it? So there must be people who must only focus on that one. If I want to make India to be to students to get formal education, what do I have to do? They have to focus on that one. So you want people to understand their goals and to go according to the goals. If there is no goal in life, then nobody can be a successful person, according to Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. And how is this dream when he's telling that technologists, technicians, scientists, they have to focus on their goals. How do we have to make it? This we shall be dealing in our next class. Stay home, go through the chapter. It's very interesting and you feel attracted. And if there are any goals, work towards your goals. Okay? We shall discuss more about this one in our next class. Stay home, stay safe. Bye-bye.